Hello there, I've done two videos on this remote now, but this video is how to use it if you don't have the code list. Which is quite often the case now because I've stopped sending it out with this. Quite annoying. I don't mind replying to you if you've got a TV or a DVD or a Blu-ray, whatever, and you need the code to get this to work. What I will say at this juncture is, if you've asked for a code, sometimes it can be several weeks till I get back to you. I've got thousands of videos with loads of comments coming through every day, and I've got a day job as well. Please be patient, I will get back to you. What you could do is look at my previous videos, because you might find your code amongst other comments and replies that I've left. So thanks in advance, and sorry in advance if it feels like I'm taking ages to get back to you. Because the find function on this is quite long-winded and can take anything from a couple of minutes to over an hour, which is a long time. And when it does find the code, you've got to be so quick on the set button. Anyway, I'm getting ahead of myself because I want to say why this is not a complete and utterly replacement to your original remote. Obviously, the original remote is going to have all the functions, whereas this will not. This is only going to be able to replace simple functions such as volume, channel, and in the course of DVD, in the case of DVD or Blu-ray, whatever, play, stop, eject, maybe menu if you're lucky. It's not going to replace everything. However, this is a really good product. And if you see it in Poundland and you've got a TV or anything electrical at home with a remote that stopped working, give this a go before you have to go and throw out and be quite wasteful of your entire product, because that is just madness. To get this to work, it's really easy if you've got the code. And my tip is, when you do find the code, write it on the back, put a bit of sellotape over it, because unfortunately, it's quite forgetful. If you've thrown it across the room for someone to catch to turn the sound down or to turn it over, if you stand on it for whatever reason and the batteries pop out the back, it forgets. And by having the number written on the back in a piece of sellotape over it, it's really easy just to set it up again. I'm going to show you now how it works. The original problem I had was that even though all the buttons on this work, I can turn it on with this remote, the volume has stopped working. Up or down doesn't work anymore. What you might want to do, before you run out and buy this, you might just want to get any standard pencil, take your remote apart, and underneath the rubber buttons there's like a black spot. And what you do is you just run the pencil over it, not too much, just enough, just a little bit. And what that'll do is it'll reset up the connection from button to circuit board. However, that does start getting a bit tedious and you end up breaking the remote eventually, so this one's all sellotaped back together. And it stopped working again, and it was getting too annoying. This is a really good replacement. All you do with this is the volume. And that's all we ever use on this, really, because it's always set up to what we always need it for. And if not, it's no hassle with the buttons. But at least we don't have to keep getting up and down just to turn the volume up and down. I'll show you what works. The first thing you do is find the function that closely matches what you're going to be using it for. Now, I've already got it set up on AUX. AUX. VCR. I mean, no one's got a VCR anymore, have they? And if you have, good for you. If you know what one is. And the code, obviously I already know, is 3060. It's really important that after that you press set, which is annoying because the LED does not flash up. You don't need to be facing the product when you're doing any of this at all, that you're just programming the remote. The closest I can get it to work means that my volume is reversed, so when you press down, the volume goes up, and when I'm pressing up, it goes down, but that is the closest I can get it to work with all them codes. It's the only way it's going to work. However, it's really easy to get used to that. It's a bit annoying, obviously, at first. Up meaning down and down meaning up. But it works. it's fine. No longer do we have to keep getting up off a settee to turn the volume up and down. That is good. Now gets to the annoying bit, which is probably what most people are forced to do now. And that is using this if you don't have the code and if you don't have the sheet. It's still quite easy, but it's just long-winded and it can take anything from a couple of minutes to over an hour. Trying to get this to tune the telly in when it forgets is a nightmare. So we don't actually use this for the telly in the living room. Oh, right. What you do is... we'll go for Sky. So you press down and hold Sky. So the light stays on. And then you press the power button. And what it's doing now is it's cycling through every single code and turning the product on and off. It'll keep doing this till it finds the code. This is the bit that's quite annoying. You've got to be so quick on the set button once it turns your product on. Because if you miss it, you'll have to wait all over again. Now that's not too much of a problem if it's found it quite quick. But if it hasn't, in the case of the TV in my case, it's a really long time, so you might as well just give up. Let's pretend it's found it now, and you'll press set, and the light will go off. And then you can just turn it on and off, hopefully, and you'll get whatever functions possible out of this. There's not that many buttons, really. You've got your four there, three, another three, another three, another three, four, and one. That's all the buttons you've got. On one of the DVD players we've got, the mute button is actually the DVD eject button, which is quite annoying. But, you get used to it, you know, you just get used to it because I'm pretty much forced to. It's either that or paying 30 quid for a replacement remote for something which is about 15 years old. How ridiculous is that? That's why the Poundland remote is great. Other things to be careful of, the buttons are quite spongy, they are quite soft. So when you're using it, they do have a tendency to stick under the plastic. It's not doing it now. Okay. Well, the best way for it to do it is with these ones on the bottom. And what you'll get is that. Which is really annoying. See that? So you do have to gently thumb them out every now and again. So it is fragile. It's not a 100% replacement, but it is really good. So to recap, if you don't feel like watching the video all over again, try and find the code, if that is not possible. You press what it is you're wanting to use, so maybe TV. Hold it down so the light turns on. Key in your number. We'll put in this again. 30, 60. Always press set. Annoyingly, the LED does not flash up to say that you've pressed set. And then it'll work. It is quite fragile. So don't chuck it across the room like you would your former remote. The buttons are quite soft and spongy. Really make sure as well that you don't rest any other remotes on top of it. Some people have a tendency to stack remotes on top of each other. This actually gets through batteries quite quick. So don't stack anything on top of it that's going to keep a button pressed down, because it's just going to keep doing that. And eventually it'll just eat the battery. It really will. It is quite delicate. It is forgetful, so always write your code on the back and cover it in a piece of sellotape. It is, as you can tell, I mean, for a pound, what do you expect? It is quite creaky, it is quite fragile, but very useful. And that's my video on my tips of how to use the Poundland remote. Thanks for watching. Please scratch with any comments, and if you ask for codes, I'm happy to give them. Thanks for watching. Scrass. Bye.